Here we see a BNSF local wood chip train hauling wood chips out of Oakdale. They're beginning the long climb up Canyon Tank Grade. The power on our local today is a UP-9, which is the foreign power, followed by a Santa Fe Warbonnet-9. Note the weathering and the burn marks on both locomotives. After rounding the curve at Canyon Tank, the local continues the 3% climb up Canyon Tank Grade through Dry Creek Canyon. Just above Hetch Hetchy Junction, the train battles the last leg of the steep grade up to Summit and passes a long siding containing storage cars. After a long climb, the train finally reaches the crossover at Summit. With the wind of full dynamic brakes, the train begins the long descent down the other side of Summit around Big Ten Curve. The engineer blows the horn for a small rural road crossing as it continues down horseshoe curves through the loops. We didn't know it then, but this will be the last shot of the Santa Fe Warbonnet that we get for the day. After a long delay, we finally see the train appear on the trestle over Warnerville Creek. However, the Santa Fe Warbonnet was no longer the second locomotive. It had been replaced by a BNSF-9 in the orange and black swoosh paint scheme. We later found out that the Warbonnet had experienced mechanical problems on the way down the mountain and had to be set off on a siding. The local rounds the last curve before slowing and arriving at the riverbank yard. After picking up another load of wood chips, the local departs the riverbank yard, again bound for Oakdale, where it will interchange with the Sierra Northern Railway. With the local now leaving the riverbank yard limits, it now begins the long climb back up Summit through the horseshoe loops. Here we get a shot of the train crossing over Warnerville Creek, coming into a horseshoe curve up through the loops. Here we get a quick shot of the train as it makes its way through an S-curve in between loops. The train appears as it battles the last curve before arriving at Summit. In full dynamics, the train snakes its way through a set of S-curves down the backside of Summit towards Hetch Hetchy Junction. Here, the train rounds a curve at Hetch Hetchy Junction before beginning the long descent down Dry Creek Canyon. Here we get a shot of the train coming off the big horseshoe curve known as Big 60 as it descends along Dry Creek down Canyon Tank grade towards Canyon Tank. The train eases its way around the curve at Canyon Tank, which was named for a water tank that used to sit on top of the flat rock on the right of your screen. Water from the tank would fill thirsty steam locomotives during the early days of the Sierra Railroad. After interchanging with Sierra Northern Railway at the Oakdale Yard, the local again heads back up Canyon Tank grade around Canyon Tank curve with a small manifest freight. Here we get a great shot of the power rounding Big 60 curve just below Hetch Hetchy Junction. The train rounds the curve at Summit before descending down the other side towards Riverbank. Here the train comes off the big horseshoe curve just below Summit, known as Big Ten, and snakes its way through Rogers Cut down the loops. Here we get our last shot of the train for the day as it crosses over Warnerville Creek. From here, the train will make one more 180-degree turn on the last horseshoe curve before entering Riverbank Yard. I hope you've enjoyed this journey with me as I caught G-scale mountain railroading action, catching -9's pulling trains over the mountain sub. Thanks for watching.